Okay, where is the video? All right. So I am going to see if people can see me now. All right. Let me see. Okay, I'm trying to get Savannah online. She is my publicist person. Let's see if I can add her to this thing. So weird that people are looking at me right now, but I can't see anybody else. Okay. Trying to get you on here. I suck. Okay, I'm inviting people. Here we go. I think you just have to accept my invitation. Ta-da! Say yes. If anybody is wondering, this is my vodka and orange juice. I actually don't usually drink vodka because I had my bad experience with it back in my younger days. So anyway, I guess it's just me. I'm on here live. Please forgive me because I can't hear you guys. So I am just staring at the page to see if anybody's posting questions and who's watching and all that. So I will be looking for your questions on here. Okay. All right. Let's see what face. What you guys got? Emmy says it's 2 friggin' a.m. in the UK, and I feel very loved. So thank you, I love you. All right. So I'm just looking on Facebook right now for questions. I'll also check questions, on the YouTube feed. And actually, I'm just gonna post right now in case people don't know that we are live. I'm gonna say we are live and then give them the link so that you guys can watch the feed. All right. Voila. Okay, so now I will answer some questions and I keep it really fast and loose. So feel free to ask me whatever you want. I might not answer you, but you can still ask the question, and who knows? You might get an answer. So let me look through these questions. All right. So, Judith, hi, Judith. You know what? Before I actually start answering any of these questions, there is somebody that I would like to talk to that I promised you guys a special guest. And we have a special announcement to make. I don't know, maybe I should wait to get a couple more views first. But, or we could just make it happen for the 7 people that are watching right now. Way to go, you guys! You're the best! All right. Let me call her right now. Who am I going to invite? Aha. I'm sitting here thinking it's so complicated, but really there is a something there where you can, like it's a little person with a plus sign. And I'm like, yeah, maybe that's where you add people. That makes sense. So let me see if I can get her on here. I'm going to invite her to the chat. All right. I invited her to the chat. Come on, you can do it. I don't know why. I'm calling you. Okay. So anyway, so while we're waiting for my special guest to come online, there she is. Hi.
Hi, CJ. I gotta turn you off on the other computer.
Yeah. It's weird in stereo, isn't it?
It is. That's like way too much, CJ, having you coming from two different directions.
There's no such thing.
Oh, well, okay. See, you've got vodka. Because I've been listening.
Yeah. What did you get?
Well, I have wine. I'm kind of a Cabernet.
I was looking for wine. I was like, what kind of writer doesn't have wine in their house? And then I realized they're all empty, which makes sense. So I drink vodka.
Well, you know, you got to go with what you got.
So anyway, we've been telling people that we had a special announcement to make. So I am going to let you take it away.
You're going to let me take it? Well, I will let everyone know that she and I talked like minutes before. This is not what she told me she was going to do. But okay. Well,
you gotta go on what you got, Letha.
Okay. Well, CJ and I have been planning. We have been
plotting.
Yeah, plotting. We have been doing a lot of things, and we have come up with a really fun story that we would like to share with all of you. Now, the thing is,
excited about it, like a lot.
Yes, we're both excited about it. And if you follow my newsletter, you know there's just been a whole bunch of exciting stuff happening, and this is one of them. And this is something that actually we've talked about, CJ and I have, for like, I don't know, probably a year.
Yeah. Yeah, really. I think when
the first time I got brought up. Where were we? Were we in like LA together?
I want to say, was it Book Bash? Where it was like there was a pajama party.
Yeah, I think it was in LA. I think that was in Hollywood at Universal Studios. Were you there?
Yes, that's where it was. Yeah, and we ran into each other in the lobby. But we had already been talking about it. And then somebody asked, you know, if you could work with somebody, who would you work with? And we had already been talking.
And I said you, because I mean, well, we do tend to meet up in bars often. Don't know how that happened.
Right.
So we've been talking about this, but it's actually more than talk now. We've got a story, we've got a plan, and we're pretty excited about it. As far as when it's going to happen, we're both working on individual things, so we don't really have a timeline. We're thinking future. But when it comes out, we want people to know that it has been well thought out, and we are really excited. So if you like twisted, if you like dark, I think we might be the people you want.
Yeah, I think it's going to be really great. So that was the big announcement. Me and Aletha Romig are going to be working on a new project together. So we've already kind of started to do a little bit of work. But we're hesitating to give a release date yet, but it's definitely going to happen. I I'm not even going to tell people like when, but just going to say, hopefully they're not going to have to wait too long. So, yeah. So that's pretty much it. It's kind of weird on video because it's just us. So like nobody can really sense our excitement. Yay!
No, no one has any idea the long hours spent actually talking on the telephone and working together on this. But no, we are very excited. And really, I mean, this is fun. I've never worked with someone before on something. So to work on a project where it's not all me, really enlightening. It's neat to see how someone else does things because
I'm really excited about that part the most. I think I'm most excited to see, and already it's happened where we've been talking about ideas and I'm like, oh, what about this? And then you'll just kind of come back with something else and be like, what if we put this in there too? And, so that's been exciting for me because usually it's just me talking to myself and I'm sure you can relate to that. So.
I do know that the voices in my head get really, really loud and yeah, no one's there to like say, hey, what about this? Cause I have to do it all myself. So no, this has been fun. And I think it's gonna be a lot more fun the longer we keep going on this.
I also think if you're not a writer, people get really sick and tired of listening to you talk about your ideas. Like, so I know like nobody else, none of my friends, you know, I think everybody's just like, please stop talking about your books all the time. I'm like, I know.
There are people out there in my real life who really think that my characters are not real people.
Yeah. Well, I tend to think my characters are real people, which is probably dangerous.
My characters are real people too. And I think our characters are real people. And so it's kind of fun to be able to talk to someone who also agrees.
Some of them might be based in part on some real people.
Yeah, but they become real. The longer you keep writing them, they become real. So
like every conversation you have is just, by the way, I might change things and this might be something that I write about. Just let you know.
Well, hey, I want to get back to your hangout. Congratulations on 4 years on Captive in the Dark. I cannot believe it's been 4 years.
Thank you so much, sweetheart. And I know like you published, like Consequence was it just a few days ago, wasn't it?
11 or August of 11.
Yeah. So anyway, so thanks for coming and joining me on the chat and making this announcement. I'm really excited about the work we're going to do together. So I'll talk to you later.
Okay. Bye, CJ. Have a fun hangout.
Bye. Bye. All right. Well, that was exciting for me. And hopefully for you too. So, anyway, I'm going to go and answer some of these questions. Let me look on here. All right. So I'm on the Facebook page right now and I am looking through the questions. Ooh. Hi, Judith, again, just because I see your stuff. All right. And if anybody's wondering how you're supposed to, well, I guess I couldn't tell you on here anyway. Yes. Hi, Kaya. Hi. I am very excited. She says, that's so exciting. Sometimes it really helps to bounce ideas off of a writing buddy. Congrats on your new project. Thank you very much. I'm very excited about it. And yeah, the whole bouncing ideas thing is going to be the best thing about this whole thing. So I know you love dark, Judith. Okay, I'm going through here. All right. All right, news about the TV series, movie, anything like that from Judith. Here is what I heard about the TV stuff. The last I heard, they were looking for a showrunner, which is somebody that does exactly what it sounds like. They run the show. They figure out, you know, who the actors are going to be and who's going to, like, direct the stuff and basically everything having to do with the show. They run the show. So, and I also heard that they were working on the pilot script. That said, I have not spoken to the producers since, I want to say, the holidays of last year. So, actually, no, we met up in LA a few months ago. Maybe it was March. They took me out to lunch. It was amazing. Dinner, actually. So we had a lot of fun, and that's all I know for right now. I think I have, like, about a year left of my option. So we'll either hear something in that time frame, or I get the rights back and we'll try again. I don't know. But right now, that's all I know. All right. And let me see. Am I writing? Yes and no, I am writing. I write what everybody's waiting on commitment. And I know that. And I'm very excited about commitment. But it's one of those stories that I can already tell is going to be very personal to me. And because of that, I feel the need to really give it its proper due to kind of, I want to put out the best possible writing that I can put out. And that's true of everything, but I think it's especially true of this project. I sort of started writing it out of a burst of inspiration when some things happened in my life. And I felt very connected to my husband and to my family. And I think when things happen, you seek shelter in those relationships. It's been a very long, very arduous year for me. It has definitely not been all sunshine and roses, and it's been very hard for me to work. So I am working on commitment right now. I kind of feel like I'm not giving it all of the passion that it requires, which makes me upset. Believe me, I wish that I wasn't so tied up in this. I wish that it was just like a story that I had an outline for and that I was writing, but it's very free form and it's very personal to me, and I really just want to do it right. So I don't have an ETA on that. I know that I do have over 50,000 words on it right now. It's just a matter of making those 50,000 words count, which at this point, I hate it. I know that hating your writing is a part of the journey, but that's where I am right now. I'm in the hating it part. So that is what I've got to say about that. I love you madly too, Tara. Thank you. Do I ever get the urge to expand on Caleb and Libby? Okay, so I've been receiving a lot of email now that Captive in the Dark is free for a while and people are going crazy and, you know, asking about it and stuff. So yes, I do. I really do. I get the urge to go back to these characters. How could I not? Because I love Caleb so much. I love Libby so much. I love their entire relationship. And I know them so well that it would be the easiest thing in the world to kind of go back and be like, let's revisit these two and talk new stories. And there's so many threads that I left open for the purpose of pulling on later down the road if I felt the need. So I don't know. Yes, I do get the urge. Do I have any plans? Not at this exact moment, but I'm not going to rule it out. I still plan on writing the Agent Reed book. So I'm very excited about that still. So yeah. Yeah. All right. I'm scrolling through here. All right. Savannah is also like texting me things. What is my favorite book? Oh gosh. Okay. That's hard to say. I read so much. I really do. If I had to choose a favorite book, a book that I can read over and over again and never get tired of, I'm going to have to go with The Vampire Lestat. I love him, love him, love him. I love Anne Rice. She's the person who kind of inspired me to become a writer to begin with. So my favorite book would have to be The Vampire Lestat because I adore Lestat. In fact, she wrote that latest book. It was like called Prince Lestat or something. I still have it on my Kindle and I haven't read it because I feel like once I read it, it's just going to be over. I don't know. I read the first page and I was like, too many feels. So, that. When will a new book be out? I already talked about that. Any book signings for next year? So I do, if you go out to aboutcjroberts.com under appearances, I have my unconfirmed schedule for 2016. I talked to a travel agent this week and she's given me some prices back as far as how much traveling is going to cost. It's really expensive when you're independent because you have to pay for everything yourself. And as I'm sure you know, I haven't had a book out, not a full length since Epilogue. So money is tight, and I gotta figure out which events I can go to and which ones I can't. So I will have an answer for that shortly. But I will do some things. I will do some book signings in 2016. I just don't know which ones I'm going to be able to do and which ones I'm not. For those that are asking about Australia, I have not, I can't even price that out yet because it's only available like 355 days out and I'm not there yet. All right. What would be your dream story to write, or have you already written it? My dream story. It's hard to say because Captive in the Dark, I started that when I was in my early 20s. And this is what vodka will get you. I'm sweating. Jesus. So I started Captive in the Dark when I was in my 20s, and I kept writing it because I would dream about it all the time. So literally, I dreamt about this book, and then I would write scenes for this book based on dreams that I had. So in that sense, I have written my dream book. I think that when I finally finish Commitment, it's going to be really beautiful. I think it's going to say a lot of things that I don't articulate so well in my real life. But I think it'll be great, you know, once I get it all out of me. But for now, I'm going to say, yeah, I've probably written my dream book, you know. All right. What else? Hi, Judith. You said you're watching. You're so funny. That was Kaya's question. Yay, Kaya. All right. Thanks, Shauna. I'm glad you like the announcement. Okay. Who wants to be on camera with me? That's a good one. If you have like a Google account, a G Plus or whatever, we should play like Truth or Dare or something. Okay. All right. Do we have questions out on the YouTube page? Let's see. Comments are disabled. You can, Giselle, you can totally put questions there. Savannah is trying to kind of corral them in. All right. Sarah Astros from Colombia asks, are we going to have more about Agent Reed and his dirty little secret? Yes, absolutely. I am committed to writing about Agent Reed. I'm totally going to do it. I would not have set up such a spectacular character and then just kind of like leave him out there. So I completely plan on writing that story. I wish there were more than one of me, so that I could like get stories done faster. That'd be awesome. Angelica from Columbia asks, will you write more about Kid? I planned on it. You know, I don't know why, but the character Kid spoke to me so much when I was writing that I was like, oh, I would love to do something. And when the opportunity came out to put the Dark Duet out as a box set, like when I did the Platinum Edition, I wanted to include something a little extra for the fans who had already purchased the standalones. And so I thought, oh, I will write this novella as bonus material and, you know, people will enjoy it or whatever. And I guess the people that have read it have enjoyed it. Unfortunately, not a lot of people did read it. So if you read it, thanks. You're part of my little cult club. I don't know. But yeah, so I had hoped to actually write like three novellas, with the one that was in the bonus material being the first one, but then it didn't really sell so well. So I'm not really sure if that's going to be time well spent, but I did hope to write more about that particular threesome because I just think it's crazy hot. Angela wants to know if you're using pants. I am not wearing pants, actually. I am wearing my pajama shorts, and I would probably show you, but nobody wants to see all that. So, all right. Let's see. Yes. Si habla español, Laura. Hi. All right. There were some other things that I was supposed to do, like announce the winner of the paperback giveaway. So I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to go out to my raffle copter, which I've already got queued up. And then I'm going to select choose a winner. And then we wait for a few seconds. And the winner of the paperback copy of Captive in the Dark is Angie. I do not have a last name for Angie, but what I will do is I will copy her winning status that she posted, and I'm going to post it out on the Facebook page. And I'm going to say, winner, Captive in the Dark, autographed. So, Angie, congratulations. I will autograph your book. In fact, if you're watching the broadcast, if you'll make a comment right under where I've posted that you're the winner and let me know how you want it, autographed, I will sign it like that and send it your way. So, good times. Thank you so much for joining the contest. You're awesome. And that is that. So, I'm going to announce the winners now. Yay. All right. Thanks, Angie. That was that. Who else did I have to announce? There was also supposed to be a Captive in the Dark contest where the winner would get like a swag pack. So I don't know the winner of that one yet. So I'm going to wait for Savannah to kind of get that information for me. And then I will talk to the winner. Let's see. You're so funny. Greetings from Colombia. When are you coming here? I would love to come to Colombia, Angelica. I really would. I have no idea when I would come out there. So few things happen. Like, I go where people invite me to go. If there's like, you know, if somebody's opening an envelope and they're like, CJ, come out here, I'd be like, okay, I'll be there. But that hasn't happened yet. So I would love to go out there. All right, scanning stuff. All right. All right, so, okay. Now I'm out here on the YouTube page, seeing if I can troll for any more questions. All right, let's see. All right. Oh, so Savannah just let me know that I wanted to give a shout out to Sarah Astros, who was the top blogger in the for the Spanish blogger army for CJ en Español. So gracias, Sarah. Okay. Oh, and she did post it. She's so awesome. Thanks, Savannah. It says, and the winner of the bucket list challenge is Zelina. So I love you so much, Zelina. You always comment on all my stuff. You always share everything. So I'm really super glad that you won. So I know you have all the books. So you say, like, I feel like I know you just from all of our back and forth. But anyway, congratulations to you. So I will get together a swag pack of some goodies that you might not have and send it your way. So congratulations. All right. And yeah, that she said Team Calavi. Calavi. That's an interesting name. All right. So what else do we have? All right. Looking at these comments. Will you write another story even darker than Captive in the Dark? That's from Giselle. Hi, Giselle. I love you, by the way. I love all of your haircut posts. So, yeah, I don't think I'm ever going to get away from the dark stuff. I think it's because I just have such a gritty sexuality. You know, I'm interested in that kind of, you know, hardcore erotica, if there's such a such a designation. So yeah, I will probably always write things that are a little on the icky side maybe for some people. So commitment definitely has parts of it that are very dark, and there, it's like a lot of emotional darkness in this book. So far, the way that I've been writing it is that, you know, it's about this marriage, but the characters are very dark in themselves, and the way that they kind of soul search and the things that they do. You know, Maya's a very self-destructive character, and I can definitely see myself in her a lot. Sometimes I am definitely my own worst enemy. So when I said that this book was kind of personal as far as the emotions, it definitely is. Captive in the Dark was also very personal for me, because I identified a lot with Libby as far as being young and naive, and you know, the world seemed so big and I couldn't control it. So yeah, I always try to write from a place of emotional truth. And being that I am a bit of a dark soul, then I think it's just inevitable that my writing will always have that flavor. Kaya asks, what's your writing process like? Do you plot or free write? Do you write in the morning or late at night? I try to plot. I end up free writing a lot of the time. And typically the best writing that I do is going to be right after 10 o'clock in the morning. I feel like I just don't even function before 10 a.m. as far as writing goes. I write in the dark too, which is terrible for my eyes. I have to wear these like thick glasses. Boop. Because, yeah, my eyes are crap because I write in the dark. I read in the dark. And so my husband's always like, turn on the light in here. But anyway, so I write in the daytime most of the time, but I write in the dark. And occasionally I write at night, which is convenient for me. Giselle says, I'm inviting you to my house. I can cook Puerto Rican food. Yay! She lives in Pennsylvania. That's awesome. I've never been to Pennsylvania, so I'll have to come out there. Can I send you my books for autograph? Absolutely, yes, you can. If you have books that you purchased, but you would like them, you'd like them autographed, you can always send them to me at P.O. Box 9533, Rapid City, South Dakota, 57709, with a self-addressed stamped envelope, and I will sign them, and I will put them in the envelope, and I will send them back to you. I'll go ahead and post that address out in the on the Facebook fan page, and I'll put it on the YouTube comments too, so people can see it. And let's see, do we have anything else? I wish I could see other people too. This feels so like I'm all alone. I'm used to talking to myself. We Colombians love you. Gracias por eso, Paula. So I'm gonna have to go to Colombia because they like thick girls out there, and I am a thick ass girl. All right, let's see. Kayla asks, can you elaborate on the new thing you've been working on? So the new thing that I've been working on is two things. I've been working on commitment, which is running really slow, and I sort of really just want to bang my head up against a wall. And the new project that I'm working on with Aletha, which honestly, like, I was, the best part about that was that when we were talking about it, like, it was just firing in my brain. And I was like, oh, thank God, because I was starting to really think, like, do I've got nothing left or something? So so I'm very excited about that. I wish we could tell you more about it, but it's one of those things where it's like you have an idea and you really can't tell anybody because it's, as a writer, that's all you have is your ideas. So, but very excited about it. I can say that it's going to be very like thriller-esque. So, as a movie, I see it as something that Sandra Bullock could probably be in, you know, if it were the early 2000s. I love Sandra Bullock. I don't care. All right. Erica Heath asks, what is Caleb's last name? Ooh, that is one. That's like a trivia question. I should probably give something away if somebody knows Caleb's last name. So Caleb, you know, Caleb never has a last name. Caleb never even had a name, really. Caleb wasn't really his name. So as far as the character Caleb, Caleb doesn't have a last name, but Caleb's real name is revealed, you know, in book two. So I'm going to put that one back out to the readers and say, do you know what Caleb's last name is? All right. So I don't think we have any more questions right now. The one thing I would say is, like, don't feel like you guys have to ask me book related questions either. What? There's like a picture out here. Oh my God, Judith, you're so cute. She took a picture of her computer. You're so damn cute. So cute. So see, you got me all flustered. Anyway, I was going to say, yeah, we don't have to just talk about book stuff. Although I am really happy that this is like 4 years since Caleb. I can't even believe it. Like, it went by in a blink. So I'm really happy about it. Let's see. But yeah, just ask me whatever. I'll have to like make up a game or something. Games with CJ. Yay. Paula's excited about the news with Aletha. I am too. All right. Oh, okay. So let's see. There are some more questions here I have not answered. Let me go through. All right. I already said, I want to know about Agent Reed. Okay. Agent Reed. We talked about that. We talked about Kid. My favorite. Oh, Judith says she has to read my favorite book. You do, because actually that's book two in the series. First, you have to start with Interview with a Vampire. They were very popular in the 90s. And it was really like very influential to me as a writer. I love Anne Rice so much. I have dreams where I meet her. I've never met her before or anything. But one time I did comment on her Facebook page and she replied. I was such an idiot too. Like, I just took a screenshot of it. I was like, she said hello to me. So, Nashville 2016. I will come get you and bring you, Erica says. I'd love to go to Nashville. I've never been to Nashville. I think that'd be a fun place to live. You know what I like about country cities like that, like Nashville's got a lot of cowboys and stuff, is that they remind me a lot of like Hispanic men, where you can go to a club and you can just dance, and that's all that they want to do. Like, if you go to a country bar or something, like, they just want to dance with you, and then they're like, thanks, ma'am, and you're like, yeah, that was fun. And if you go to a salsa club, you know, then you just dance, and then they'll be like, all right, bye, you know. They're not just like rubbing all up on your stuff. Not that I mind that sometimes. It's good to feel wanted. And Erica's asking about Caleb's last name again, and I haven't said what it is because I'm waiting for somebody else to say, because it's definitely mentioned. How is the experience of bringing your books to Spanish readers? Okay, so Sarah asked me that, and you know what I would say is that when I went to the Spanish market at first, I didn't intend to. I found out that somebody had taken the books and translated them, like the fans translated it, and then it was out there in Spanish kind of everywhere, and I was like, huh, because it is piracy, but I don't know, mixed emotions. But I had been trying to get into the Spanish market forever because I'm Puerto Rican. My family, I have a lot of family that doesn't speak English, and I wanted them to kind of be part of it. And they couldn't be because I didn't have a Spanish language. And so it was a bit of a tough thing. On the one hand, I was grateful, that I could then take this material and share it with the Spanish readers. But then at the same time, I was like, I got pirated, which kind of sucked. So, I don't know. Let's see. Am I wearing pants? No. All right. I'm going to refresh this page, see if I've got more questions. More questions. More questions. I do that all the time, too. This is the weirdest part about this is that because I'm by myself, I think I'm talking to myself, but I'm not because people are watching me. That was probably weird. All right. It says, okay, I'm trying to watch and ask a question. First, who do you think is a hot actor at the moment? And second, in your mind, did Rafiq mean for Caleb to find a girl he would possibly have a hard time letting go of? That's from Jesse Griffin. Okay. Who do I think is a hot actor at the moment? You know, I'm a huge Supernatural fan. Like, I'm just a freak for it. I really am. I don't miss an episode. I watch over and over and over and over again. So really, it's got to be the Winchester boys for me. I love them so much. And I've got my little t-shirt collection too. Hot Topic really needs to make stuff for girls my size because they buy all this stuff for the kids and I'm like, what the hell? I want to wear it too. And then the second question is, in my mind, did I think that Rafiq meant for Caleb to kind of find a girl that he wouldn't be able to let go of? I do not think so. I think that Rafiq and Caleb's relationship was definitely complicated because, I mean, Rafiq raised Caleb from when he was a boy, so he definitely had feelings for him. I don't think that you can take care of somebody and not eventually have feelings for them. So I think that Rafiq did love Caleb, but I think that even though he loved him, I think he still saw him as a tool that he could use, a means to an end. And that's ultimately what made the story or their relationship so incredibly sad, was that it was kind of one of those things where it's like, no matter what, it was going to end badly for Caleb. So, no, I don't think, I wouldn't say that Rafiq was like 100% bad, but he was definitely, he definitely knew what he was doing and when he was manipulating Caleb. That's the way that I always imagined it anyway. What's your favorite song right now? Oh gosh. I like that cheerleader song. And I also like anything by Jason Derulo because I think that's really awesome. I like that trumpet song. There's no words to it, but it's bouncy. My favorite movie has got to be, well, obviously I'm wearing a Star Wars t-shirt. Yay! But I'm going to have to go with The Fifth Element. It's one of my favorite movies ever. I watch it like a lot. What do I collect? Aside from books and what do I collect? Receipts, books. I was going to make a terrible joke. I won't. What do I collect? I don't really collect anything aside from that. I just collect books. That's, I mean, a lot. I got a bad book habit. All right. So those were from Angela. Hi, Angela. Oh, my God. So everybody's got to know Angela. She's awesome. She helps me a lot. She's, you know, been a really good friend to me. She got started, you know, reading my books and stuff, and then she would just kind of chat with me. She's one of Caleb's kittens. And when I went on hiatus a few months ago, she kind of went out there to the fan page and she would post things every now and again just to kind of keep stuff active. You know, help Savannah out because Savannah's my publicist and she does a lion's share of things. But so anyway, she's awesome. Hi, Angela. Okay. What do you say to Charlie when you met him, took a picture with him? Oh my God. Okay. So here's about the time I met Charlie Hunnam. So I was online on Facebook when the Cantu sisters, I'm sure you guys know the Cantu sisters, right? Amanda, Crystal, you guys got to know them. Anyway, so they're on there and they were talking about Charlie Hunnam and this and that and how he's Caleb. And I was like, yeah. And they said, he's going to be in Texas. I said, no freaking way. He was at a motorcycle rally. It's called the Lone Star Motorcycle Rally. So then I said, you know what? I'm going to see if I can go down to Texas. And I completely rented an RV, and I got in the RV with all of my friends, and we drove on a Friday night, 24 hours, from South Dakota all the way to Texas in one night. We spent one night, and then we drove 24 hours all the way back, and we did it all to meet Charlie. So I went in there. We had a little VIP stuff, and we went, and I saw him, and oh my God, he's so pretty, you guys. Like, you think he's pretty, like, on TV, but he's super pretty up close. So I saw him, and I smelled him, and he smelled very manly. I'll put it that way. Not like bad. It's just he's a naughty boy, and you could smell it on him. That's all I'll say, because that's his business. So, so anyway, I had a copy of the books, and I had told him, I said, you know, my fans, they love you so much. They love this series, and I always imagined you, you know, as the guy. So he looks at them, and he's holding my books in his freaking hand, and he goes, are they dirty? And I was like, melt, panties falling off. So I was like, yeah, they're a little bit dirty. And he smiled, and so I gave him a copy of the books that I signed, and then I had him sign a copy for me. And I'm not afraid to admit that I was a little tingly in some places, thinking about the fact that maybe, it's quite possible, Charlie Hunnam read my books and totally had a boner. So I actually have this on my wall. Ta-da! He gave us a poster, and he signed it, and I've got it hanging up in my office. So I love you, Charlie, wherever you are. I'm going to stalk you again someday. All right. I like how you hate Donald Trump and his stupid idea of kicking us Mexicans out of here. Right? I mean, I wouldn't say that I hate Donald Trump. I don't really hate anybody, but he just says a lot of stupid stuff. And I have this very big problem with racism in particular, because I grew up in Southern California and I'm Puerto Rican. But if you're brown and you live in Southern California, you're going to get a lot of that. You know, everybody thinks you're an immigrant and, you know, where's your green card and this and that. And I'm like, you know what? I'm an American. But regardless, I have feelings on the subject. So, but yeah, I usually don't get political at all on my page. I was just like, stop saying stupid stuff, please. I hate when our politicians just say stupid things. Like, I feel like they get into it for the right reasons, and then they just, I don't know what, get seduced by money and power and all that fun stuff. I would like to be seduced by money and power. I would like that very much. All right, so looking. What else do we got? Are there more questions? Yes, Paula said it. She said Caleb's real name is James Cole. Go, Paula. Go, Paula. You know what? If you PM me your address, I will send you something. I'll send you like an autographed card or whatever for sure. So just PM me your address, Paula. That was awesome. It's James Cole is his last name. So let's see what else we got. All right. Ta-da. All right, those are older posts. Yeah, Kai is a huge Supernatural fan. I know, I'm telling you, if you lived closer, we'd probably be pretty tight, because the few times that we have talked, we have got a lot in common. Supernatural, give me Sam, give me Dean. I'm a slut for either team. Shakes pom-poms. Yes, me too. Oh my God, I want to be the meat in that sandwich so bad. You have no idea. It's sick, actually. I will actually admit a secret that very few people know, and now that I guess like the world will know, but sometimes, occasionally, I'll write a little Supernatural fan fiction something, and I will throw it out there anonymously for people to read. I would never, ever, ever, ever tell people, you know, I would never share publicly what it is, but I love it so much that I actually sometimes write little fan fiction stories for that. So, all right. I hope you guys are entertained. So weird when you don't have any feedback. I feel like I'm a comedian who is doing a set in front of an empty audience, you know? I'm just like, ba-dum-bop, and it's like nothing. There's silence, and I'm just like, yeah, it was funny. I was pretty sure that the crowd thought that it was funny. In fact, I might try out some jokes on you guys, because sometimes people tell me that I should be a comedian, and I thought about it, and I'm quick, like I'm witty, you know? If somebody says something to me, I have a very snappy reply, but writing jokes, I know, because I have a friend who is a comedian, is hard work. So shout out to my BFF, Riley James, love you. Judah says, did I win a used bra for stalking you a lot today? I don't know. I'm wearing one, which is unusual. You guys should feel so special. I'm wearing a bra for you. So, Judith, if you really want my bra, I'm a 38 double D. So, you're welcome to it. I smell pretty good. I took a shower and everything. All right. Oh, yay, Kaya. Thanks for the encouragement. I am damn sure we were getting some serious mischief. I need to bring you out to a book signing sometime, because I have to meet you in person. It's necessary. Sarah Astros Rojas wrote Brock equals Caleb. Oh, my God. He's way hot. This Brock guy, I keep seeing him everywhere. He's so incredibly hot. But, you know, I'm pretty sure he's taken. I mean, somebody's probably taken this guy, right? I mean, I'm not going to kick him out of bed or anything, but, you know. All right. What else we got? You're cracking me up, dude. Hi, Ilona. How are you, sweetheart? Thanks for watching, and thanks for coming to all those events and stuff. You're awesome. I love it. Every time I see you at a book signing or something, you've just got the sweetest disposition. I actually see a lot of my readers, over and over again at different things, which I love, because believe it or not, I get kind of nervous going to things. So it's always really nice when you show up somewhere and then, you know, you see a familiar face. Especially since sometimes I show up and I'm not wearing my glasses, because I look like a nerd in them. So sometimes I won't be wearing them, and I'll walk into the hotel lobby, and I know I'm there for a book signing, okay? I swear to God, I'm not walking around thinking like, oh, I'm so famous or whatever. But when I go to a book signing, I know people are there for the book signing, so I'm famous at the book signing. So I'll be walking through the lobby, and I'll think somebody is maybe looking at me like, oh, is that CJ Roberts or something? So I'll just be like, hi, and they're not there for me. They're just like some random person. And I just talk to them, and now I feel stupid, you know. But sometimes it's for me. Yep. All right. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Somebody wrote about Captive in the Dark in Spanish. It's sexier in Spanish. It really is. I don't know. Just something about the words. I don't know. It's hot. It's hot. All right. Do we have any more questions? Oh my God, Kayla. I can't believe you're watching this on your big screen TV. Hi, country. Oh my gosh. So we're family. This is on my husband's side. This is my sister-in-law. Oh my goodness. She has the cutest. The cutest babies, her and George. Kayla, post pictures of them babies, because they are so stinking cute. My little nieces and nephews, I just want to eat them, probably with some kind of barbecue sauce. I have this idea that baby meat is really tender. I probably shouldn't say that, but they're probably delicious. I'm just saying, if you eat people, baby's got to taste the best. Karen says, so excited to hear you have a new project going with Aletha. Love you both and your work. Thank you so much, Karen. I think it's going to be really great. Like, just the idea, I'm so excited about it. I wish I could tell you, like, when you have an idea that you think is going to be really amazing, you just want to tell every single person, but then our idea would maybe get stolen. So I had a question via email, and it was for an aspiring writer. And she wanted to know about the editing process and how to kind of get over nerves and stuff. So when you write a book, it's your baby. You love it, love it, love it. But the thing is, you need an editor. You need one. I don't care how many times you've read your book, you need an editor. You need someone who is not attached to it to look at it and go, this is good, this is crap, this needs a comma, duh. So how do you kind of get over your nerves? Obviously, the first thing I would say is if you know somebody, that's the best, okay? You're gonna have the most trust in somebody that you know. But aside from that, if you're new to it, like I was, a lot of trust goes into it. And I found Katie. Hi, Katie. In fact, Katie just started her own editing company. I believe it's called, underline this. I'm gonna check. She's incredible. I was online looking for an editor. And what I did was I went out to Amazon and I found people that were reviewing books that were similar to mine or just books that I loved and seeing, you know, people's reviews. And I looked through Katie's reviews, and when I was looking through her reviews, I felt like we had the same feelings about a lot of different books that we had read. And then I said, you know what? She seems like she's a fan of the same kind of books that I enjoy to read. So I reached out to her and I said, you know, would you give mine a read? And she did. And I'm telling you, it was the best relationship that I built during the writing process, because not only did she read it and give me my initial feedback, but then she stuck with me like for years, the whole editing process. So I really give her a lot of credit for taking my writing to the next level. And if anybody is interested in getting anything edited, I highly recommend her because she's amazing. I obviously don't want to share her with anyone because I'm selfish, but I love her enough that I will share her with people. So I know it's hard to let go of your work, but the fact of the matter is, if you don't put it out there, nothing's ever going to happen with it. So it's a big leap of faith. Find the right person that you're going to have a good editing relationship with. Don't just send your work to like anybody. That's like the dumbest thing ever. I mean, someone could just take your work from there. No, you want to have a relationship. Typically what I do is I'll send my chapter one, and then the editor will look over chapter one. They might give me, ask for a deposit. I give them a deposit. It's usually something low. Like I paid, I think, $50 for an edit of my chapter one. So I gave my chapter one, and this isn't Katie, this is other relationships, but so you give your chapter one, they look it over, they make all the edits and stuff, and then they send it back to you, and then you can see whether this editor is going to give you helpful feedback or not very helpful feedback. And it's a good way to test the water, and then you didn't just give them your whole book either. So I recommend sending a sample. And if you like what they do, then go ahead and pay them to do the rest. And just because you get a note from an editor doesn't mean that you have to take the note. A note is a note. That's exactly what it is. You're the writer. You're ultimately responsible for deciding what goes out and what doesn't. I've been really lucky as far as people giving me good advice. So, all right. So I'm going to post the link to Katie's website. And it is called, underline this. So, posting it out there. Ta-da! Highly recommend her. All right, so anyway, that was one writing question that I got via email. Ilana wants to know, am I coming back to Florida soon? Is it weird? I feel like I should talk instead of type. Oh, I wave back. Thanks for the sweet words. Oh, thanks. And you're very welcome. You deserve them, obviously. I'd like to come back to Florida. I have family out there, so I'm sure that I will be there at least visiting. But I had been out there for Book Bash, and I don't know what's going on with Book Bash right now. So, all right. Let's see what else. Hey, somebody posted Supernatural. JJ says, hi from Puerto Rico. Girl, you are crazy. Don't eat baby meat. How come? ¿Por qué? It's probably delicious. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. Baby meat has got to be good. It's got to be good. I remember when my baby was born and I was like putting lotion on her and stuff. And then I was like, you know what? I'm not going to talk about eating babies anymore. I'm just not going to talk. But whatever. Thanks for the gift. I am the biggest Supernatural fan. You guys don't even know. I'm serious. It's bad. Can't wait to meet you in Texas. Jan says, can't wait to meet you too. I'm very excited about Texas because I'm going to meet up there with my girl, Laura. What's up, Laura? All right. Erica says I look smoking in the spectacles. Thanks. You think so? Maybe if I just like, if I'm like, Erica, you've been a very, very bad girl. Like that, maybe. I don't know. I'm a dork. You know what's so funny is that I write, you know, smut for a living, and I'm all sexy and stuff on paper, but in person, I'm such a big nerd, and I'm a spaz too. Like, you know, somebody will look at me because even though I'm married, you know, you still go out there, you still want to know that you got it and stuff. And so, you know, every once in a while, somebody will be like, you know, hey girl, whatever. They'll just be like, I'll be like, I'm just. Ridiculous. I'm ridiculous. And then like when I'm trying to like be sexy with my husband, it's not okay. It's not okay. It's based, he could tell you it's bad. I'm surprised that he even will get into the bed with me. I'm like, we're married. I pretty much own you. You have to have the sex with me. So let's see. How many times have I read Captive in the Dark? And I'm not even kidding you. At least over 100. At least over 100 times. Because it took me 8 years to write the thing. So I've read it over 100 times. Recently, though, it's probably been a year since I've read it, though. And I had to stop reading it because every time I reread my work, I go, oh man, I wish I could have like done this a little bit different or done that a little bit different. And it's time to leave that one alone and move on to something else. But yeah, I've read it over 100 times. Giselle said, how do you handle readers who clearly feel some type of way and dislike your books? Well, you already know I eat babies. So I'm kidding. You know what? Since Captive in the Dark went free, I've gotten more one-star reviews, even though there's a freaking warning on there that says, this is what's in this book. If you don't like this, don't read it. But, you know, whatever, people are going to, I don't know, they like controversy. So how do I deal with it? Honestly, I don't. If people read it and they post their little review or whatever, and that's it. I don't engage with negative reviews. I let people have their opinion. I have told my readers sometimes, like, please don't go out there and harass the one-star reviewers. They just want attention. Some of them have something valid to say. And a lot of times I think I know people are not going to like my work, and that's okay by me. I just don't like it when people make ignorant comments. Like, oh my God, he kidnaps this girl. I'm like, yeah, that was pretty much in the blurb. You're describing the blurb, in which case your opinion is invalid as far as I'm concerned, because you're not giving people any new information. I prefer both positive and negative reviews to contain some sort of constructive criticism. If you hate it, tell me why you hated it. If it's based on the premise, well, then you already knew the premise, and I just think it's ridiculous to even talk about. So sometimes I think people make ignorant choices like that. They read something just for the sake of being able to post it out on Facebook and be morally outraged. Some people don't even finish the book before they're morally outraged. Whatevs. There's nothing I can do about it. I just got to be true to myself. And I'm not writing for them. You know, I'm writing for people that rate me at the fours and the fives, right? The fives, they love you. The fours, they really liked what you did. And they really like what you did. And a lot of times that's where you're going to find your constructive criticism is in the fours, where they're going to be like, I loved it, but you know, I think everybody else, it's just going to be a book they read, in which case they might read me again. They might not, but the audience that I'm really trying to connect with are my 4 and 5 star reviewers, because I think those are the people that appreciate my work the most. Those are the people who are going to buy my books. And so those are the opinions that I respect. Yeah, go Paula. Again, I just saw your little thing where you said his name. Have you read Captive in the Dark in Spanish? Is this a question for me? Because yes, I have read it in Spanish and it is hot. What is your favorite scene or chapter from the series? Mercedes asked that question. What is my favorite scene? Honestly, my favorite scene has to be the opening scene. Because originally that wasn't in the book. That was something that when I sent it off to the beta readers, they were like, we don't really understand Caleb. We don't really know who he is. And so I was like, okay, I have to get into this guy's head. I have to try and be him. What am I going to do? And I wrote that scene of him in the car, watching her from afar. What is he thinking? What is he doing? I really kind of tried to slip in his skin. And that was the first time that I had done that. So I enjoyed writing that scene a lot, because it was the first time that I kind of, instead of being Livy, I switched into being Caleb. And I definitely like wearing him a lot better. He gives me swagger. But from the entire series, oh man, some of those sex scenes are pretty damn hot. I mean, if I say so myself, right, which I do, because I guarantee you, I am sweating when I write them. Sweating. Okay. Looking through the comments, seeing what people are saying. All right. All right, so Kaya said, what do you do to unwind when you're not being a captive in the darkness of your office after 10 a.m.? What do I do to unwind? Okay, so this is going to be really boring. I read a lot, and I karaoke. I love to karaoke. I try to go at least once a week. And if I'm not karaokeing, then I like to ride my Harley. I'm a Harley rider. I started that as 2012 was when I got my Harley and I started riding with the guys and stuff. And I enjoy that because I have a lot of anxiety. I get very nervous about a bunch of things. And when I'm on my motorcycle, which you think it was something that I would never do, I get on my motorcycle, I go 80 miles an hour, and the whole time I'm just like, don't die. But like, that's all I'm thinking. So it's less stress. So, and I have a lot of fun. All right, question number 2 from Kaya. When did you come out as a writer? What was the process like of being open about what you write and connecting with your fans more? Okay, so when did I come out? I didn't have a choice about coming out, because once I told my mom, that's it. Like, it was a done deal. And, you know, when we first started, I had my regular Facebook page, and I just put it out there, not even thinking. And then once my mom saw it, it was like, forget it. It's out there. I had some real mixed emotions, because my mom is one of these people. She's very, very Hispanic mom, where she's just like, oh, sweetheart, you know, I noticed that the mom in the book was really mean and this and that, you know. I hope that you don't think that I was like that. And I'm like, who is talking about you? You are not the character in the book. But that's my mom. So it was a little bit weird coming out at first because I write sexy stuff and it was my mom. And my brother made the trailer and my brother was like, just give me the gist because I'm not going to read this because I'm not going to read smut that my sister wrote. And I was like, good plan. The process of being open, you know, I'm still not all the way open sometimes because as successful as I've been in my career, I still have my moments where people ask me what I do. And as soon as you tell them that you're an independent writer, they give you one of those where they're like, oh, that's nice. Like, good for you, you know? And I'm just like, yeah, it is good for me. Like, that, or they go, oh, you know, I don't know. So, and then there's of course the professional stuff. Like when I go to my kids' parent-teacher conferences and they ask me what I do for a living, I just like to say that I write adventure stories for adults. So that's what I say about that. So I'm not fully out. My neighbors, I think they think I sell drugs because like the cars are always here, but you know, we ride the motorcycles and we do all kinds of stuff. And so I'm sure they wonder what the hell we do. And as far as interacting with the fans, my fans are amazing. They've always been so good to me. Like without them, not to mention the fact that I wouldn't have a career, but I mean, there's been real times in my life where I've needed friends because I live out here in South Dakota. I didn't grow up here. I was in the military. And so I kind of ended up here. And even though I have my motorcycle friends here now, it's all guys. And, so I spent a lot of time alone and, so it's really nice when, you know, I'll put stuff out there. I recently went through some stuff and my fans were like so incredibly supportive and they sent me all these messages, not just commenting on the Facebook page, but a lot of you guys sent me like private messages and things, just kind of telling me to keep my chin up and keep going and how much you guys love me. And there was I spent a lot of time crying about that, but, so yeah. I have no problem being open and honest with my fans. They've always been really open and honest with me. So, all right. Savannah is like, get out here. I'll read these questions. I'm coming. I promise. Where are we? All right. So what else we got? Let's see. All right. Giselle asks, how do you handle those readers who dislike the book? Okay, I said that. Judith asks, am I having any signings in California? I actually just got invited to do a signing in Los Angeles in January. And since I'm from LA, I'm definitely going to get into that. So as soon as I know more details, then I will make an announcement. But I plan on being in LA in January. I think there's also something going on in San Francisco, too. And what am I drinking? This is vodka. Vodka and OJ, and I'm like down a blast of it. Oh, Jesus. So, all right, let's see what else we got here. Okay, Maya asks, what do you personally think about everything that happened to Nancy? Okay, personally, what do I think? Did she get what she deserved? I don't think anybody deserved that. I don't think anybody deserves that. So no, I don't think, like, I don't condone that kind of violence. But at the same time, I really have a problem with women hating on other women in the same way that I have, you know, with the race stuff, it's with the sexist stuff. You know, I'm all about female empowerment and girl power, and I just don't think that women can rise above unless we start to lift each other up, you know? And so I think anytime, you know, like you have the situation where there'll be some guy and like two girls are fighting over this guy. I'm like, why are you fighting over this guy? You should be teaming up to kick his ass. I mean, that's what you should be doing, not fighting each other. What's that for? Probably some of my feelings that went into that is that there are women who were involved in the sex trade. And I think that stemmed from the fact that there was a case where these two teenage girls were holding other teenage girls hostage, you know, and I was just kind of like, first of all, what kind of sick, twisted kids are these? But aside from that, as women, how are you going to do that to another woman? I just don't understand it. It's anyway. So did she deserve what she got? No, because I don't think anybody deserves that. But I also, you know, I didn't spend a lot of time agonizing over my decision either. I have a real problem with women treating other women poorly. All right, let's see. Judith asks, how many times? Okay, blah, blah, blah. Sarah asks, do you have an odd habit? I have lots of odd habits, not the least of which is the fact that I talk to myself constantly. I've probably done it while you've been watching, but I talk to myself all the time. I used to share an office with my husband, and then he kicked me out because I kept talking to myself, and then he would answer me, and then I would get mad at him for talking to me. So then he moved me in here. So now I have my own little office where I close the door and talk to myself all day long. Other weird habits? No. Well, I'm sure other people would say I have them, but I don't know what they are off the top of my head because they're just my habits. That's not really a weird habit. That's not something that I do all the time. Okay, so I am going to do, let's see, some final calls for questions. Kaya says, thank you for sharing your adventure stories for adults and answering my questions. We love you. I love you too. I love all of you guys. I really do, sincerely. Just so much for my self-esteem and my sanity and everything else. So, like I said, I'm going to do a final look around here to see if we have any more questions. Susan says, so excited to meet you in Seattle. I can't wait to go to Seattle. I'm actually going to Seattle because Taryn Fisher lives out there and I'm stalking her. So if you see Taryn, I'm coming for you. Watch her like leave Seattle before I get there because she's mean. Yep. All right. Ooh, Erica said, you're on death row. What's your choice for your last meal? Easy. Pork chops and potato salad because my mom makes the freaking best. Like, it's so good. Or like arroz con gandules and some chuletas, which is basically like, I don't know what you call the rice in English. It's like rice with something. I don't know what the little beans are called in English. What are gandules in English? Does anybody know? And then like her pork chops are the jam. They're bone in. And I like, I will bite the hell out of that bone for like a half hour. So good. So that's what I would eat. As far as what I would drink, I feel like I'd want to be really, really drunk if I was going to be like, I'm about to die. I'm gonna get loaded. To be like drunk, go to death row and say something cool. Like, have you seen my shoes? And then they would kill me. And then I'd be like, those are my last words. Like, have you seen my shoes? I don't know. Oh my gosh, Kayla posted her baby meat. So cute. So cute. Yes, I would eat your babies, Kayla. They're just so cute. All right. Okay, I think that's probably it for questions, you guys. I don't see anything else in there. I hope I got to them all. Let's see, does Giselle have another one? Giselle says, thank you for your time, beautiful. Thank you for saying my name, which sounds hot. Giselle. all right, guys. Anyway, I love you all so much. Thanks for watching and thanks for hanging out. I hope that I got to all of your questions. Next time we do this, I'm going to try and think of some games that we can play because that seems like it might be fun. So muchos besos and good night. So. Bye, you guys. I'm going to go watch some Supernatural. All right, here's the really fun part where like I go out here and I try to figure out how to turn off my webcam because I'm super special. All right, I'm going now. I'm fading away. You know what? I'm gonna Criss Angel it. Have you guys seen Criss Angel? Because I'm gonna Criss Angel it. Okay, here we go.